Welcome to the Eye of Truth. In this channel, I've covered the mysteries of space and other physical phenomena outside of the ordinary. In this video, I'll be covering something that could very well be the greatest mystery of the universe. That's me, you, and every other living thing. In other words, life. Life is the greatest creation in the universe, but it's also its greatest mystery. I'll explain why in this video. But first, consider the following. You are seeing microbes and single-celled organisms under a microscope. There's a link to the source channel in the description below, if you're interested in seeing more. Why am I showing you footage of single-celled organisms? You might be surprised at how complex their behavior really is. Now let's see how they eat. You can see here how these single-celled forms of life prey on other life, not unlike animals stalking the savannas of Africa. Although not shown here, these organisms also seek out mates for sexual reproduction. Without brains or even nerve cells, these single-celled organisms are able to act in very complex ways. It just seems so strange. What causes them to act? Where does their consciousness come from? We still don't fully understand how they work. Now, let's take a look at this image and guess what you're looking at. It seems to be part of some kind of precision machine. In fact, this is a part of a bacterium called a flagellum. Bacteria require propulsive force to move forward. The flagellum is an appendage used to generate this propulsive force. I'll explain this in more detail later, but it seems hard to believe that this structure developed purely through chance. This flagellum is a simple yet efficient propeller. People often compare a flagellum to an F1 engine. However, that's a poor comparison. An F1 engine pales in comparison to a flagellum. Why? A flagellum is constructed from just around 20 types of proteins. Even so, it has an energy conversion efficiency of nearly 100% and rotates at an astounding speed of anywhere from 200 to 1,000 times per second. In comparison, an F1 engine is constructed from around 5,000 parts, but operates at a speed of only around 300 RPS, with an energy conversion efficiency of only around 50%. An F1 engine is the result of years of advances in technology, and yet cannot even keep up with the lowest form of life. Next, let's take a look at the human body. The human heart beats 60 to 80 times per minute. That's around 100,000 times per day, or 2.3 billion times over the course of a human life. The heart pumps 70 grams of blood each beat. That's around 7,000 liters of blood per day. In order to continue to work over the course of an entire lifetime, it's said that the heart requires an amount of energy roughly equivalent to the energy required to send 100 artificial satellites in orbit around the world. The heart is able to pump blood throughout the entire body in just 50 seconds. If you live to 80, your blood will have circulated throughout your body as many as 120 million times. Other parts of our bodies, including our immune system and digestive organs, continue to function non-stop as long as we are alive and healthy. All of these complicated processes are possible thanks to the work of the approximately 30 trillion, some say 60 trillion, cells in our bodies. Each day, approximately 600 billion of these cells die, only to be replaced immediately with new cells. It takes 1 month for skin cells, 4 months for blood, and around 10 years for bone cells to be completely replaced. Let's drill down even further. It's said that around 98% of the atoms that make up the human body are replaced within a year. Our brains are unlike other organs in that brain cells are not replaced. However, the atoms and molecules that make up brain cells are constantly replaced. This means that the brain in your head is different from the one you were born with. In other words, in terms of both biology and physics, you are a different individual than you were 1 year ago. Even so, you are always you. So, am I really the same person as I was before? What does I really mean? I plan to cover this in a future video. Let's take a closer look at how strange life really is. Most of the cells in our bodies contain a nucleus. The nucleus contains genetic information called DNA and RNA. It is under the control of the nucleus that each cell divides and regenerates. Each of the 30 trillion cells in our bodies has its own life cycle. And yet these cells work together in a sophisticated manner to maintain life activity. For example, red blood cells carry oxygen throughout the body. White blood cells attack germs and other foreign material invading the body. Liver cells break down toxic components. Besides these major cells, we also have minor cells that provide them with support. So, how do these 30 trillion cells work together? Actually, cells make use of various chemical substances to transmit information. There are several methods of communicating this information, but they are all similar to the flagellum I discussed earlier, in that they are simple yet efficient. This communication allows cells to understand what they need to do, so that they can cooperate while fulfilling their own roles. Humans are blessed with intelligence. Even so, a group of people operating under a chain of command would require an advanced level of teamwork to work together well. So why is it that these cells, without any intelligence or consciousness, appear to work together so well? Of course, some might say that it's precisely because cells have no intelligence that they can work effectively together. If that's the case, then how do cells with neither intelligence nor consciousness follow instructions so exactly? The celestial bodies in space behave according to the laws of physics. We've known this for several hundreds of years. There must be certain rules followed by the cells that make up life, and by the single-celled organisms I covered earlier. When will we understand them? The strange thing is, this great unsolved mystery is only the first step when it comes to living things. An even greater mystery is our brains. The human brain contains around 100 billion nerve cells. These nerve cells use electrical signals to transmit information. It's interesting to note that this method of transmitting information has been in use since several hundreds of millions of years before the birth of modern civilization. Once again, the mechanism here is both simpler yet more efficient than what we can produce with modern science and technology. These nerve cells are connected using structures called synapses. Whenever the human brain receives any kind of information, these nerve cell connections become stronger, or new connections are made. It is through these extremely tiny changes that our brains are able to store new information. Even as you watch this video, your brain is storing the information by altering the connections between many nerve cells. This mechanism allows a human to store an amount of information equivalent to approximately 2.5 million gigabytes over the course of their life. However, this is just one example of the amazing things the brain can do. The most noteworthy is the ability to think. The brain is a collection of atoms and molecules, which have neither consciousness nor intelligence. Even so, we are able to think how these elements come together to form our brains. What is it that gives this mass of atoms and molecules consciousness and the ability to think? And how does it happen? This becomes stranger and stranger the more you think about it. However, even this isn't the greatest mystery of life. Living things have this curious characteristic of consciousness. Based on what I've covered so far, you might conclude that consciousness is created by the brain. That is indeed what's commonly believed today. However, the brain might be no more than a simple receiver of consciousness. What do I mean? Let's consider a thought experiment from David Eagleman, an American neuroscientist. Imagine there is a man living in the desert, and he is shown a radio for the first time in his life. By twiddling a knob, he realizes that he can change the sound coming from the radio. He removes the knob and finds a cable. By changing the position of the cable, he can change the sound coming from the radio. he decides that the sound must be generated by this cable. What he doesn't realize is that the sound actually comes from a remote signal generator. This is one way to consider where consciousness comes from. There have also been some interesting research findings on the nature of consciousness. Recent research has theorized that we may not have any free will at all. In other words, although we appear to be able to freely determine how to feel or think, the concept of free will may not even exist. The single-celled organisms I discussed at the beginning of this video are composed of just a single cell. Even so, they are splendid forms of life. Interestingly, many of the cells in our bodies do not differ much structurally from these single-celled organisms. To a certain extent, you could say that we are all giant collectives of countless tiny forms of life, cooperating at a highly sophisticated level. We like to think that we are the masters of our bodies, but the true masters might be these tiny life forms. Life, from simple-celled organisms to complicated humans, is full of mystery. In previous videos, I often stated that life is several tens of thousands of times more complicated than any precision machine created by humans. After watching this video, I think you can understand why. This also explains why I disagree with the argument that life was created simply by random chance in nature. The more that we study the universe, the more we begin to understand things. However, the more we study life, the more complicated things seem to become. Thank you for watching.